In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Welcome to our online worship for the 12th Sunday after Trinity. In our readings, Moses is called by God from the heart of the burning bush, and Paul urges us to follow the way of righteousness with real commitment. And Jesus says that true discipleship means taking up the cross and not avoiding it. As we gather at home or in church to worship, Christ comes to us and is with us. He blesses and heals us, and we are united with him and one another through our communion. I shall ask the Father, and he will give you another paraclete to be with you forever. The Spirit of Truth, whom the world can never accept. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Human sin disfigures the whole creation, which groans with eager longing for the God's redemption. We confess our sin in penitence and faith. We have not always worshipped God, our Creator. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We have not always followed Christ, our Saviour. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
We have not always trusted in the Spirit, our guide. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Almighty Lord, grant you pardon and forgiveness of all your sins, time for amendment of life, and the grace and strength of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray to the God in whom we put our trust. God of constant mercy, who sent your Son to save us, remind us of your goodness, increase your grace within us, that our thankfulness may grow. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Reading from the book of the Exodus. Moses was looking after the flock of his father-in-law Jethro, the priest of Midian. He led it to the far side of the desert and came to Horeb, the mountain of God. The angel of the Lord appeared to him in a flame blazing from the middle of a bush. Moses looked. There was the bush blazing, but the bush was not being burnt up. Moses said, I must go across and see this strange sight, and why the bush is not being burnt up. When the Lord saw him going across to look, God called to him from the middle of the bush. Moses, Moses, he said. Here I am, he answered. Come no nearer, he said. Take off your sandals, for the place where you are standing is holy ground. I am the God of your ancestors, he said, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. At this, Moses covered his face, for he was afraid to look at God. The Lord then said, I have indeed seen the misery of my people in Egypt. I have heard them crying for help on account of their taskmasters. Yes, I am well aware of their sufferings, and I have come down to rescue them from the clutches of the Egyptians and bring them up out of that country, to a country rich and broad, to a country flowing with milk and honey, to the home of the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Hivites, the Amorites, the Perizzites, and the Jebusites. Yes, indeed, the Israelites' cry for help has reached me, and I have also seen the cruel way in which the Egyptians are oppressing them. So now I am sending you to Pharaoh, for you to bring my people, the Israelites, out of Egypt. Moses said to God, Who am I to go to Pharaoh and bring the Israelites out of Egypt? I shall be with you, God said, and this is the sign by which you will know that I was the one who sent you. After you have led the people out of Egypt, you will worship God on this mountain. Moses then said to God, Look, if I go to the Israelites and say to them, The God of your ancestors has sent me to you, and they say to me, What is his name? What am I to tell them? God said to Moses, I am he who is. And he said, this is what you are to say to the Israelites. I am has sent me to you. God further said to Moses, you are to tell the Israelites, the Lord, the God of your ancestors, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, has sent me to you. This is my name for all time, and thus I am to be invoked for all generations to come. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And a reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Let love be without any pretense. Avoid what is evil. Stick to what is good. In brotherly love, let your feelings of deep affection for one another come to expression and regard others as more important than yourself. In the service of the Lord, work not half-heartedly, but with conscientiousness and an eager spirit. Be joyful in hope, persevere in hardship, keep praying regularly, share with any of God's holy people who are in need, look for opportunities to be hospitable. Bless your persecutors, never curse them, bless them. Rejoice with others when they rejoice, and be sad with those in sorrow. Give the same consideration to all others alike. Pay no regard to social standing, but meet humble people on their own terms. Do not congratulate yourself on your own wisdom. Never pay back evil with evil, but bear in mind the ideals that all regard with respect. As much as possible, and to the utmost of your ability, be at peace with everyone. Never try to get revenge. Leave that, my dear friends, to the retribution. As Scripture says, vengeance is mine, I will pay them back, the Lord promises. And more, if your enemy is hungry, give him something to eat. If thirsty, something to drink. By this, you will be heaping red hot coals on his head. Do not be mastered by evil, but master evil with good. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. Anyone who does not take his cross and follow in my footsteps is not worthy of me.
Alleluia.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
From then onwards, Jesus began to make it clear to his disciples that he was destined to go to Jerusalem and suffer grievously at the hand of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and to be put to death and to be raised up on the third day. Then, taking him aside, Peter started to rebuke him. Heaven preserve you, Lord, he said. This must not happen to you. But he turned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle in my path, because you are thinking not as God thinks, but as human beings do. Then Jesus said to his disciples, if anyone wants to be a follower of mine, let him renounce himself and take up his cross and follow me. Anyone who wants to save his life will lose it, but anyone who loses his life for my sake will find it. What then will anyone gain by winning the whole world and forfeiting his life? Or what can anyone offer in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man is going to come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and then he will reward each one according to his behaviour. In truth, I tell you, there are some standing here who will not taste death before they see the Son of Man coming with his kingdom. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. There is a sense in which, particularly in Matthew's Gospel, Jesus is seen as a second Moses. Moses delivers the people of Israel from their slavery in Egypt to their freedom in the Promised Land. And we heard in the Old Testament reading the story of the call of Moses when God spoke to him from the burning bush. It's important, I think, in that story that the people of Israel are suffering and in need of that homeland that God has promised to them through Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. And they're suffering at the hands of their taskmasters in Egypt, and they're suffering in a way that prevents them being the people God has called them to be. Because God has called them to be people who have been set free. And that's what Moses must do. He must set them free from their slavery in Egypt and lead them into the newfound freedom in the Promised Land, where they can worship God, where they can thrive and prosper, where they can receive God's blessing and be a blessing in the world. And then we move on to the story in this evening's, in today's Gospel reading. Jesus tells his disciples that he is to suffer and to die, that he will be put to death and will be raised up by God. And Peter can't tolerate this. That mustn't happen. Peter says, you know, heaven forbid, heaven preserve you, Lord. This must not happen to you. And Jesus' response is brutal. Get behind me, Satan. Because Peter is trying to tempt Jesus into doing something that he must not do. He must not avoid the cross and the passion, his death and his resurrection. That is what he has to do. That is what God has sent him for. And what Peter doesn't understand isn't just that that's what God has sent Jesus for, but that same suffering, that same taking up the cross, is what is required of Peter and the other disciples and all other Christians. And indeed, of those first disciples, many of them we know were put to death. And although the stories are traditional and probably legendary, we have a story of Peter being crucified upside down because he won't be crucified as Jesus was, Andrew being crucified on a diagonal cross, Bartholomew, he was supposed to be skinned alive, and others of the, and James we know was put to death by the Jewish authorities. Others of the disciples also suffered greatly as they followed the path that Jesus has set. What Jesus wants Peter and the other disciples to understand is that he is walking along that path of suffering into new life, because he will die and rise again, and that they too will walk with Jesus on that path. They too will suffer, and through their deaths, they will share in the resurrection, the new life that Jesus comes to bring. And for us, it's the same. We walk with Jesus, and because we walk with Jesus and die with him, we are raised and given eternal life. That is God's gift to us. And that taking up of the cross is a necessary part of being set free into the new life, into the risen life, into the life of the resurrection. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For Peter and Ruth, our bishops, for the leaders of our sister churches, for all clergy and people, and for the churches of our parishes in this benefice. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For Elizabeth, our Queen, for the leaders of the nations, and for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For our communities, for every city, town and village, and for all the people who live within them, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For good weather and for abundant harvests for all to share, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who travel by land, air, or water, for the sick and the suffering, for Peter our Bishop, for prisoners and captives and for their safety, health and salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For our deliverance from all affliction, strife and need, and for the absolution of our sins and offences, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Hasten, Lord, the day when people will come from east and west, from north and south, and sit at table in your kingdom, and we shall see your Son in his glory. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. We are all one in Christ Jesus. We belong to him through faith, heirs of the promise of the Spirit of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. God of wholeness, in your Son Jesus Christ we find forgiveness. Grant that through this Eucharist we may be forgiven our sins. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord is here. Lift up your hearts, lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is indeed right, it is our duty and our joy, at all times and in all places to give you thanks and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. For he is your living word. Through him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you have freed us from the slavery of sin, giving him to be born of a woman and to die upon the cross. You raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right hand on high. Through him you have sent upon us your holy and life-giving Spirit and made us a people for your own possession. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom. And with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Accept through him, our great High Priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts, in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, and with him, and in him. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Most merciful Lord, your love compels us to come in. Our hands were unclean, our hearts were unprepared. We were not fit even to eat the crumbs from under your table. But you, Lord, are the God of our salvation, and share your bread with sinners. So cleanse and feed us with the precious body and blood of your Son, that he may live in us and we in him, and that we with the whole company of Christ may sit and eat in your kingdom. Amen. Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Take this and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Water, so my soul.
fear of the Lord will bring healing to your body and refreshment to your bones. God of all mercy, in this Eucharist you have set aside our sins and given us your healing. Grant that we who are made whole in Christ may bring that healing to this broken world. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Merciful God, you have called us to your table and fed us with the bread of life. Draw us and all people to serve your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. The Lord bless you and watch over you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look kindly on you and give you peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.